Alaska Fire Service and the State of Alaska Division of Forestry have several remote field stations located throughout the state. Some field stations are staffed during the fire season, while others are only staffed when there are fires in the area. Field stations may have caches, mess halls, barracks, and/or wall tents. Fire camps may be primitive. There may be no showers, porta-potties, catering, or tables and chairs, but with a little ingenuity and imagination, you can make camp more enjoyable. It is not uncommon to construct facilities with materials on hand, such as logs, cardboard, parachute cord, plastic sheeting, or anything else that may suit the purpose. Spike camps are the rule on large remote fires to maximize line production and conserve helicopter time. When choosing a location for spike camps, there are a few considerations. Proximity to the fire line, distances from supply points, keeping in mind supplies are delivered via helicopter, paracargo, and/or boats, and then will have to be moved to camp. Having enough area to support the amount of personnel that will be using the camp. Changing water levels of rivers, streams, and bogs due to rain, and the availability of firewood. In spike camp, having a fire under a shelter or a tarp is a necessity due to ever-changing weather conditions. Keeping your camp area tidy and organized as fire behavior may also dictate moving camp quickly. There are two options when dealing with human waste: burying it or building a latrine. When building a latrine, dig a hole that is deep and wide enough to accommodate the amount of people that will be using the facility. Order toilet paper, bug dope, pick, and chlorinated lime. Also remember, before packing up spike camp, that the latrine needs to be taken down and the hole filled in. A clean camp is vital to personal health and safety. Backhaul should be a daily occurrence to minimize the potential for bear curiosity. You should place your garbage bag inside a burlap sack. Keep in mind, backhaul will be moved by hand many times. Please utilize fiber tape to secure everything being transported. Consider burning cardboard if conditions warrant. Initially, food provided at the beginning of an incident or on short-duration fires will consist of MREs. 3 days of MREs before fresh food is delivered is standard. However, there are situations where the use of MREs does not make sense, such as incidents that are expected to go on for many days or weeks, or fires that are closer to the road system. Fresh food boxes are an alternative to MREs. Fresh food boxes must be ordered 3 days in advance so that there is time for them to be packed and delivered. Some of the items that you will find in a fresh food box are meats, vegetables, cheeses, assorted snacks, plates, utensils, paper towels, foil, and miscellaneous condiments. In preparation for fresh food, ensure that adequate pots, pans, and cooking utensils are on hand or ordered. On a typical incident, all personnel share the responsibility for gathering firewood, meal preparation, cooking, and cleaning. Cooking food over an open campfire is the norm. When fires are not appropriate or firewood is scarce, both propane and white gas stoves are available. Some EFF crews will have a crew member stay in camp to perform these duties. Also, EFF camp crews can be utilized at large fire camps to maintain facilities, cut firewood, and collect garbage. There are two types of fresh food boxes, Box A and Box B. The fresh food Box A is designed to feed 4 people for 3 days. Box B is a supplement and a scaled-down version of Box A for short-duration assignments or when an incident might be coming to an end and not as much food is required. Note, there are slight differences between AFS and DOF food boxes. Tundra fridges or coolers are made by cutting and rolling back the organic tundra mat and digging a hole. Next, construct a lid with available materials, your tundra mat, cardboard, etc. Place perishable food in bags and store in your tundra fridge. If you're in an area where you have limited permafrost for refrigeration, ice chests and ice can be ordered. It should be assumed that all natural water sources are infested with giardia and are not suitable for human consumption. Drinking water will be delivered in 5-gallon cubitainers or QBs. Water delivery is expensive. An average cost for remote fire water delivery is $1.86 per gallon. Local water sources and water treatment is an option to consider. Washing with QB water is frowned upon when other water sources are available. In Alaska, commissary may be provided to meet the extended employment needs of EFF personnel assigned to fire suppression duties. Commissary is not guaranteed, and it is up to the discretion of fire management officers and incident commanders as to whether or not it will be granted. If granted, commissary orders for tobacco products, socks, and hygiene items will be accepted on the fifth day of a remote assignment for delivery on the seventh. EFF crew personnel are required to bring necessary personal gear with them as a condition of hire. Commissary should not be relied upon for personal needs. Mosquitoes and other insects are common throughout the state. You should procure a head net and mosquito repellent before assignment to the field. Be prepared for all weather types, including cold, wet weather. Keep a 3-day supply of food and water in case you get weathered or smoked in. A good rule of thumb for planning is 1 cubitainer and 1 case of MREs per person per 3 days. While in Alaska, you may be near lakes, rivers, and streams with good fishing. Alaska Department of Fish and Game requires that all anglers have the appropriate licenses and stamps. Bears are very common on fires as they are attracted by food and garbage. Keep eating and sleeping areas separate and never take food to your tent. Keeping a clean camp is essential. Bear behavior may be demonstrated by a bear standing sideways, trying to impress you with its size, or snapping its teeth aggressively. Bears are temporarily deterred with fusees, chainsaw noise, or helicopters. If a bear becomes a problem, options include moving camp, demobbing the fire. If all other practical means to protect life and property are exhausted, consider killing the bear. This requires a qualified gunman, fish and game notification, and preservation of the head, hide, and claws. Cow moose can also be very dangerous. They should be treated with the utmost respect. Keep a safe distance and avoid getting between a cow and her calf.